May I now request Mr. Manjeev Vora, Executive Member, Chandigarh Management Association, to introduce our second speaker of today, please.
Good evening. Very informative session by Mr. Hardesh Madan. I think everybody is like that way the technology is changing and we have to adopt it. Now our second speaker of the day is Ms. Harit Mohan, CEO Signicent. A brief profile of Harit is Mr. Harit Mohan is the CEO and founder of Signicent Information Solutions, LLP, a successful patent research and analytics company based out at Mohali. He did his BTech with honors in biotechnology from Kurukshetra University in 2006 and got admitted to the prestigious IIT Madras and completed his MS in biotechnology in 2008. Parallel with his work at Signicent, he has done specialization courses in entrepreneurship from University of Maryland, College Park, United States. In his 10-year of experience in the IP industry, he has held several key positions. He has worked with clients from over 20 geographies and has advised to CXOs, general counsels, patent professionals, R&D heads, and inventors. He has a bucket of experience spinning to areas like patent prosecution, litigation, searching and analysis, landscaping and competitive intelligence. He is also an active follower and contributor to PIUG and LES group at USA. He has also been at a strategic and competitive intelligence professional, SCIP, conference in Washington, and two of his research works have been published in 238th American Chemical Society, National Meeting, and elsewhere scientific journal, respectively. Now let me present to you is Mr. Harit Mohan.
All right. Thank you so much for you know, very nice introduction, and the previous sessions have been really intriguing. This topic is very close to my heart. The reason is that we've been actually working in this space with my company Signicent. So some of the topics that have been named today, blockchain technology, artificial intelligence, we have been working with US companies on the same technologies. And an example batata hu aapko, Digital India ka right example is in my home. My daughter asks Alexa, that I was telling, Alexa, what is the probability of rain tomorrow? And Alexa says, there are 80% of chance it will rain tomorrow. Papa, hum chutti le lein kal. So that IoT, that Alexa thing is right in my home. My daughter, she is 4 years old. She can, you know, handle Chromecast right now. I don't know how many of you have used Chromecast. Chromecast is basically an app which you can connect to the internet and you can see the movies, the things that you want to see. So way beyond schools will teach them, you know, as you know, has been told previously, ki you cannot type. So if she wants to listen to a song, for example, say any song, so she don't know how to type. You know, the schools do not tell you that quickly. So what she do is she go to the Google Assistant and say the command there. I want to listen, so she'll say, you know, hello, I want to listen to, say, DJ Wale Babu Mera Gana Chala De, and Google plays it on YouTube for her. That's the power of, you know, the internet that we are talking about today. Having said that, so, you know, formal thanks to everybody here who have invited us. A little about Signicent. So we've been into 6 years into the space of IPR. Basically, what me and my company is doing is, after getting my post-graduation done from IIT, we've been actually helping companies, a lot of companies, in protecting what is coming out in the market from the impact of innovations, the Digital India and all. So we have been actually registered in India, and we also have registered in United States as Signicent LLC. What we are going to talk about is so a little formal of what I'll skip the sections which has already been covered in the by the previous speaker. So there are basically 9 pillars, to be very honest, that are covered by Digital India. So they have been by Modi ji, who introduced this in 2015 very formally. So they have been, you know, spaces like we're talking about broadband highway, the access to the mobile technology, publical internet. It has been, you know, also embedded with a lot of e-apps that you see, a payment system, of course, the way you can, you know, if you see a pit hole, just click the photo of the pit hole. If you see the garbage, just click it and upload it, and, you know, people would reach there to take the necessary action. So it's all possible because of digitalization that we are seeing today. Innovation and digitalization basically go hands in hand. So my area is that if I can understand the audience here, how many of you are, just by a raise of hands, how many of you are in the academics areas? I mean, lecturers, professors, teachers, okay. How many of you are in manufacturing setup? Let's say they manufacture something, okay, great. How many of you are, for example, in the government sector of medical, healthcare, all right? And then there are, of course, you know, bureaucrats with us and IAS with us who will be the major in decision making. The way we are handling it is like this. So the end product of everything that you do is, say, research and development. You know, at the end, you make something, aapko jachha banayenge, and you will try to sell it, you will make money out of it. So this organization, this digitalization is, you know, leading to more and more innovation, and that's where we are helping in. So anybody who's familiar with what are patents, have you heard about the term patents or trademarks or copyrights? Most of you have. Okay, so the reason that we think is when you put your hard-earned money, when you put your lot of efforts in the space and somebody copies it, bura lagta hai, bahut bura lagta hai, and it's loss of money. You know, for example, if somebody copies your website content, if somebody copies of what your researcher have been doing in your labs and you just copy it and publish it as your name, it hurts. So what we are trying to do is we are trying to protect them. The end aim of is to protect them. So the dimensions, there are many things. So as this technology is making it more faster, cheaper, across borders with the help of digitalization, our aim is to basically help it. There have been some cases, so I'll pick up. For example, Uttarakhand last year rolls out an hot air balloon through which the Wi-Fi is being sent to almost everybody. So remember, if you cannot put wires to everybody's home, they just floated a hot air balloon, which can stay there for about 15 to 20 days and can provide internet, right? Perfect example. There have been other examples. Google has you know, initiated. Has somebody used Wi-Fi, for example, at railway stations or at airports? Some of you have. In most of the airports in India, for example, this is there. But railway stations are also coming up to it, which is, you know, again, connecting a world to the internet. Then there have been other examples, you know, the Aadhaar card is being tested globally now. Modi also launched a lot into Singapore, the Aadhaar card scheme. I mean, they like the technology also, it will go there. So we are, you know, we're not just generating technology, we are also helping in controlling black money. Marketing, Rupee has been a card. I think Friday there was a web conference by our Prime Minister, and he kind of appealed that do not use a Visa and MasterCard. You know, as patriotic, use the Rupee card, which is basically from an Indian origin, so that the money that you transact using e-commerce or when you're shopping in malls, that basically goes to the Visa and MasterCard first, and using this card would make that money stay in India. So that's another appeal that has been done in the recent web conference. Entrepreneurship is one thing that has been you know, given there. I think other than anybody else, I am an example of this. Not so long back, I think people have heard about the Great Recession. I was the victim of it. I got a good double-figure job right after my IIT. What happened was, funny story, 2008 recession was there. And I was in Mumbai with Thomson Reuters, one of the leading in the information journal space. And I was like lay off in about a month's time. 1 month with good training, sent back to home. And there were the 15 more people from my colleagues from IIT Kanpur, IIT Delhi, who had the same fate. Had there been no internet, had there been no research, I could have been, not able to do what I am doing today. I have already traveled about 15 to 16 countries. I've seen entire Europe, almost been to 8 to 10 times in US. I've seen technology. The previous session talked about the smart plugs. I have that one in my home. So when you say, switch off the light, the lights gets off. You need not, jaake band karne ki jarurat bhi nahi hai. And it's a Samsung made smart plug. So jaise hum log agar adapters hote hain, 3-pin plug hote hain, it's the same plug. You just put in your light button or a lamp in it. So you can control it with the app also. Main ghar aane se pehle AC on kar sakta hun, so that, the ambient temperature is reached by the time I'm home. So this is how, technology is changing ways that we are doing it. So there have been a lot of boost to R&D and my company is also working on the same line. We have had help a lot of companies in the same space of biomedical to mechanical to electronics to almost every field that you would see in the snapshot. I'll skip this slide, but since intellectual property is what we do, I'll just spend another 5 minutes considering the time constraint we have. Any guesses what are patents? Anybody would like to say what are patents? Because there have been people who said we know patents. So any rough idea what are patents? Right. Great. So sir has suggested that it's basically jab aap kuch R&D karte hain and you kind of publish it and you want to keep it secret. A little more refined definition would be you submit it to government and then you earn 20 years monopoly for what you have made. And then if somebody copies it, you can litigate him. And this is, you can ask for fines for them. So that's patents. What are copyrights? Copyrights is for something like, books. Agar hum mein se koi shayar hai, poetry likhta hai, that is basically copyrightable. If we do blogs, content of it is copyrightable. So all that fall under copyrights. What is trademarks? If I say, for example, a punchline, I am loving it. Can you recall the trademark of it? McDonald's, right? Some of you guessed it right. I am loving it. So I don't even say McDonald's and, most of you were able to guess it. If I play a jingle, say ting, 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 which brand it is? Parle, okay, any other guesses? Britannia, exactly. So see, have I said Britannia? No, right? I just said ting, 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 and you were able to recall it. That's the power of trademarks. That's the power of how you collect IPR or the brands that you have made to technology. That's trademark. Apple, most of the youngsters, including me, would like to buy an Apple. Why? The same phone is being made by MI or maybe the other thing with a little more features, but then I'm ready to pay 3 times more. Reason is the brand power. If I ask the audience here, which is bigger, Apple or Samsung? Any idea, Apple or Samsung? Raise the hands who says Apple. Okay, and who says Samsung? Okay, for the others, the dinner is about to come. Just bear with us. So the answer is Samsung. If you go back to your home, look around, you have fridges, you have ACs, you have microwave, you have televisions, you have everything from Samsung. What does Apple do? Just mobiles as of now, or iPads, or iPods. And now they are into Apple, but Apple TV and all yet to come in India. So the idea is the brand power makes you look like that Apple is far bigger, which is not the case actually. So that's the power of brand. So without wasting time, a small exercise, I know you may be a little lethargic, but this will just waken up a few more eyes. Can you guess which form of IPR would this be out of the names here? Patents, copyrights, trademarks. So which will this be? Trademark, perfect. Then the next one, 5.someone by Chetan Bhagat. Copyright, perfect. How about this camera? Patent. Secret formula of Coca-Cola. Trade patents and trade secret. Now let me just also give you this an idea. While patents have a 20 years life, trade secrets are to be kept for any number of time. You can keep it for 100 years, you can keep it for 100 days, depends of how long you can maintain the secret. So that's the thing that we have to consider. Next case, this small device to sharpen the mustache. Patent. Why? Because this is like Jugaad. We understand Jugaad, right, in India. So if anything that is there which can solve a problem, it's basically patentable. Some of us have been charging mobiles. Imagine a situation jab ghar pe we need to charge our mobile phones and there is no table available. What do? We balance it on the head of charger. If it vibrates, what happens? It falls down. So simple jugaad could be put a hook and it sticks there, patentable. So we're talking about not very high R&D cost. It's simple solutions to practical problems that we see, which is patentable. Next thing, this painting copyrights. Okay, mobile phones, patent, because it's technology. There are a lot of things into it. This logo, trademark. All right. So with this, you know, I kind of sum up here. So if basically you're looking into this space, it's important that digitization is important and the innovation that is coming out, be it any form, be it in the form of patents, trademarks, copyright, content, research articles, it's important that you protect it so that others cannot copy it. Thank you so much.
Harit, with the patent technologies and innovation taking place, some of the companies, they do take the initiative for the cost reduction and some change of small structure of the molecule and get repatented. Around 90 to 95% of the work is already done by the previous company or the patent holder. How to come across with this type of problems?
Okay, so if I got your question and I refine it, so basically talking about a little refinement of what is already existing, and the question is, can I repatent it? Is that correct? Okay. So that's, I think, the major challenge today. And if I go a little mathematics, IOTA is a term that I've been told, when I was schooling. So the little difference, the differential that you have can still be patented. Now, how is the catch? Let me give you a very practical and simple example. Supposedly, my company, hum ghadi ki wo needles banate hain, supposedly. And I do a adjustment to that needle, ki jaise bahar weather change hoga, needle ka color change ho jayega. If it is sunny, it changes to orange. If it is night, it changes to black, and so on and so forth. Possible? You can, you know, put heat sensors, or you can make it digitalized with time when you can do it. Now, thing is, can I sell the entire watch? No. Why? Because I have a patent on needle, just choti si cheez jo hai. That's the difference that I have created, not the entire watch. But if I have to still sell that entire watch, I have to still go to some bigger player like Titan, Timex, or other big players. And I have to tell them, either take license of my patent, ab humse le lo and pay us. Ya sell kar dijiye unko apni technology. But agar aapko phir bhi khud hi banana hai, you have to pay them for the licensing, end licensing of their technology. So yes, you can patent it, the small iota, the small differential that you're creating, but it may not give you the rights to sell the entire product, which is just a part of it. Does that answer your question?